Welcome to this developer quick take on Lightning Message Service in Lightning Web Components and Aura Components. My name is Peter Chittum, and I'm a developer evangelist at Salesforce. In this short video, I'm going to walk through how we implemented Lightning Message Service in Lightning Web Components and Aura Components in the LWC Recipes sample app. Let's go take a look. Now for LMS in Lightning Web Components, we're doing imports from ES6 modules in order to get access to the LMS features. So on the first line of code there, you can see where we're importing the subscribe and publish functions along with message context from the Lightning Message Service module. And the message channel itself is also an import from the at Salesforce space. For LMS in Aura, there's a simple markup tag that actually represents the message channel component. And there are just a few attributes that you set. If your component is a subscriber, you'll use onMessage to identify the event handler for when a message is received. And then there is a scope and a type attribute. The type attribute is, of course, the thing that points to the message channel that you want to either subscribe to or publish to from this component. As I said, we're going to be looking at the implementation of Lightning Message Service in the LWC Recipes app. The Recipes app is one of our sample apps that the developer relations team maintains, and you can actually find them at trailhead.salesforce.com/sample gallery. So this is the LWC Recipes repo, and if you want to take a look at any of these examples, there are instructions for installing them here. The actual Lightning Message Service implementation is found on the Message Service tab once you stand up the app and start running it. The three publishers up above publish to a message channel when one of the contacts is selected from the list. The subscribers down below are listening on that same message channel. They receive the message and then load the contact record that was selected. And again, in this video, I'm just going to focus on the Lightning Web Components and Aura implementations. Here you can see the actual message channel that we're implementing. If you're not familiar with Lightning Message Service, the API name of the message channel is just going to take the file name here, record_selected, and it will append an __C on the end of it when we see it in code. That's actually the only thing that is reference checked when we save this to the org. None of the other metadata here will be reference checked. In the Lightning Web component, in the markup itself on the publisher, the key thing that I want to draw your attention to here is the onContactSelect event here with the handleContactSelect event handler. It's this event handler that's going to actually publish the message that we're going to send to LMS. Of course, the actual code that matters in a Lightning Web Component is in the JavaScript. In that JavaScript, you can see the imports that we're doing here for the features we need from the message service. In this case, we have the publish function and the message context. And then, of course, the message channel itself is going to be imported as well. The message context is implemented with a wire adapter, so message context gets used here. And the nice thing about that is anything to do with the lifecycle of your LMS implementation is going to then be handled in sync with the lifecycle of the component. So anything that needs to be destroyed or detached from, it'll take care of that for you. Now, as we said, we have the event handler handle contact selected. We create a payload for that, and then we pass that into the publish function along with the message context and the message channel that we're going to publish to. So pretty straightforward as far as APIs go. So let's go take a look at the subscriber. There's really nothing to see in the case of the subscriber. There's nothing in the markup itself that is relevant to Lightning Message Service. I just wanted to point out that this is a fairly straightforward Lightning card implementation. And of course, we need to populate certain values from the database for the selected contact record. And how that's going to take place is if we take a look here at the subscriber JavaScript, again, we have our imports from message service. In this case, we're getting the subscribe function, and there's our message channel. Now, this particular Lightning Web Component is subscribing is as part of the connected callback lifecycle event. So once we add this component to the DOM, connected callback will be invoked. That'll invoke subscribe to message channel, and that in turn calls subscribe. We're going to set that subscription into a local property, and then we identify, of course, the message context, the message channel, and an event handler for that that you can see right there that simply takes the record ID and assigns it to a local property. One thing to note is that by using the wire adapter for message context in the context of a subscriber, the subscription itself will be unsubscribed when the component is destroyed. So the wire adapter wires everything to do with LMS up to the lifecycle of the component again here. But the nice thing is I never need to invoke unsubscribe when I actually tear down my component. Let's go take a look at the Aura components now. As we saw, the Aura implementation is simply the Lightning message channel tag. And anytime you have that with LMS, of course, the key thing that you have to have is what's the message channel that you're going to be using. In this case, this is our Aura publisher. So all we have to do is identify the message channel itself. And then down here in the markup of the component, we have the handler that's going to actually invoke the publish call. So there's that handle contact selected. And just like we saw in the Lightning web component, we construct the payload and then we call publish and pass that payload into it. Let's go take a look at the subscriber. Again, there's the Lightning message channel tag and there's our message channel we're subscribing to. In this case, because we're using on message, that's the thing that's going to tell us that this is actually a subscriber. Let's go take a look and see what happens on message. So here's handle message, that's our actual event handler. And this is actually nothing to do with LMS. I just thought I would show it because, you know, obviously, what are the kinds of things that you would typically do with LMS? Well, one could very well be take some data that has been passed over LMS and then go and retrieve some data from somewhere else, either the Salesforce server or maybe some other integration. So that wraps up all of the code related to Lightning message service in Lightning Web Components and Aura. I've been talking about Lightning Message Service a fair amount at developer groups. As part of that work, I've put together some content that I want to share with the community. This particular PowerPoint presentation contains a lot of the slides and a lot of the figures I've been using to talk about Lightning Message Service. In addition to that, there's one slide in particular here I'm just going to go to. So slide number 14 has a bunch of links to different resources, different code samples, and also to Trailhead modules that use Lightning Message Service. So if you're looking for different ways to use and implement features using Lightning Message Service, go take a look at this presentation on SlideShare, and hopefully that'll help you out. I hope you found that useful and helpful. And if you did, please make sure to click like down below. And of course, make sure you subscribe to the Salesforce Developers YouTube channel and click that bell to get notifications for new videos. Thank you.